virtually every African policymaker is talking about diversification because of the commodity crisis, the falling in the price of commodities across globally, which has challenged emerging markets and developing countries. But and in my country, we talked a lot about it, but I just started thinking, we have been talking about this for so long. We only actually started doing it during my last time in government. Mm-hmm. We working really hard at diversification. What does it take?
It was hard for you as well.
It was hard. And I have to say that I think the talk is talk and a little bit lazy. If you truly want to diversify, you need a plan. And this is why I look to countries like Singapore, who, you know, that have with no natural resources, they have a diverse economy. You look at Dubai, that over 30 years methodically introduced one idea or the other, particularly in the area of services, that has now made it one of the hubs, not only for business, but for leisure.
Yeah, but it had 30 years of oil revenues to pay for that.
Well, it started the thinking when it still had oil revenues. No, I'm not, you know, and they started thinking, how do we do this? So my thought for us is, yes, we all want diversification, but until we sit down and we have consistency now to achieve it, there's something that I think is missing in our countries. You need a social contract. If you have a benign dictator who has a vision, like in Singapore, and stays on and drives it year after year, it works. But in a democracy, which is what we want and what we have, you also need some other approach. That means you need a social compact where the population agrees that no matter who takes over government, they are going to continue developing certain things in certain ways. That's not happening in many of our countries. What you find is a new government may come in and they may go off the things that were there before, they may not continue them. They may decide to put in their own ideas across many countries.
Okay, but how do you change that? How do you make those governments stick to the social
contract? That is why I think you need a conversation country by country. That's why I'm putting it on and saying that we cannot just take the lazy attitude of talking about it and not really actually sitting down in country, across countries, to have a conversation about what does this really mean? What did those other countries we admire so much? So, you know, many African countries run off to Dubai now for holidays, for business. You run off to Singapore. So many missions going there to see what they've done. But when seeing it, but internalizing that it took consistent effort. So I think we need to start a conversation about what does it take. And that's why I'm excited at CGD, because CGD tends to kick off these kinds of, you know, sort of difficult conversations for ministers and policymakers to realize that they actually need a plan.